Hello everyone, praise the Lord. As you know, I made a rapture puzzle video series about the coming of the Lord, and I have been praying a lot about it after I posted it because I have received the revelation with a whole heart from the Lord, and that part I'm confident that we pass over into the kingdom in the glorious month at Passover. And so while I was recording, I have received a message from the Lord, which is a way of communication between us truly for the past 20 years, and it means trouble. It means more delay, it means more perseverance, endurance, or greater press in the spirit, or more waiting. And originally he gave it to me and worded it this way.
Sometimes the biggest disappointment of disappointments are the greatest blessings. And ever since when he wants to tell me something and I'm not paying attention, then he flashes these numbers into my eye. And throughout this recording, if I haven't seen this triple-digit number 555 at least 50 times, then none. But the sign didn't stop with posting the videos. It just kept coming back to me, and while I was ignoring it when I was working on the video because I was very much on fire and very enthusiastic and that seemed unimportant, I could no longer ignore it afterwards because I knew something is wrong. And when the Lord has been tugging on my heart during the recording, I already knew it in my spirit even then that the information on the Austrian impact is wrong. And ignored it until the end. I'm sorry. Thank God for mercy. And I do say that in my spirit, the Austrian impact happening on the end of March is not checking out, and it did not check out even then. And I believe that the warning for 555 was just about that. I really didn't want to face the problem because there was a prophecy going out that the asteroid will impact the Earth somewhere between March and the end of the year of 2018. And because Pastor Tridi here have seen that dream that everybody was lifted up during the asteroid impact and tsunami, in my mind, the rapture was connected with the asteroid impact and the tsunami repeatedly. Therefore, as the Lord has revealed that we pass over around the end of March, I concluded that the asteroid must come at the same time. That's how it came into existence. Which makes sense. Made sense to me. We also received messages from visions and dreams. Many people see themselves going up during a meteor shower, and the rapture will take place during this time period after the opening of the sixth seal, the seventh seal, and as the meteor shower is coming and as the asteroid impacting the earth. And then it came to the second trumpet judgment, which is the asteroid impact. And as I went on reading Revelation chapter 8, then came the third and fourth trumpet judgment, which will happen immediately after the second. Everything seemed to line up verse to verse. So this is how this whole interpretation of the scripture of Revelation chapter 6 and 8 and the trumpet judgment came to me and from me. But the space of half an hour between the sixth seal and the seventh seal, immediately the time we still have after the opening of the sixth seal, which really is the beginning of the day of the Lord, maybe it represents a half a year in which we can really press hard for the mark of the high calling. Of course, we continue walking from that beginning all the way through the soul harvest is over, and then we start building the kingdom in the millennia. It's just the beginning, but yet to have a strong beginning, to have time to put our act together before some major devastation comes, such as, for instance, the earthquake at the Madrid fault line, which will split the United States into two, or the tsunami, which some people saw dreams and heard that 22 million people perished. I do not know how effectively we can work at that time on our callings, because we are going to be all about souls and rescuing people and all about just emergency rescue mission. And then comes the great revival. So perhaps we are going to have a time, a certain time, that would allow us to do our utmost to align with the divine will, with the dreams and visions that the Lord has given us over the years, and now that the manifestation begins in April, that we are still having just a little time to live in peace and not in chaos or total persecution, because persecution will also increase as the Antichrist is revealed, as the New World Order comes, as they start forcing the mark of the beast. Of course, this should not affect us, but are we not going to be all about rescuing the woman, the left behind church, and to help the people into the kingdom? I say yes, we all are going to be about the harvest. But the vision, for instance, one of the vision the Lord has given me is to establish a rescue cell. And I have heard Louis Weigel saying that they are building a safe haven and that she knows about other people contacted her who are going to build a safe haven because they haven't even purchased the property yet since they don't have the money yet. And the same situation applies here. So if it would be that we immediately go into the worst part of the tribulation, I don't see how we would be able to come and even with supernatural acceleration establish these facilities. So there should be a time of peace after our redemption, then we can work very effectively. And I believe that's what the Lord is calling us to do. And that's why he was keep warning us, warning me not to send out the email, because I wanted to send out an email to friends and family telling or warning them about the coming of the Lord and repentance, and also wanted to talk about the sudden destruction that is coming so they would understand what's happening if they haven't heeded the call of repentance. But he stopped me because the sudden destruction will not come at the time I have interpreted. Now, there is another issue here. When are we going to have the rapture? Is it going to be after the fourth trumpet judgment, as I said? Or will it be after the seventh, as the scripture says, at the last trump? But why did I say on the fourth? That is because I believe the seventh trumpet rapture refers to the second rapture, refers to the rapture of all those who came into the kingdom or repented. The next three trumpet judgments are very severe, and they are coming after of the revealing of the Antichrist. They are taking place at the time that the implementation of the mark of the beast is setting the stage and the word, martyrdom. So that certainly refers to the first 3.5 years of the tribulation. No matter which way I look at it, the asteroid impact will not take place immediately at the time of this Passover, but later this year. And I remember prophecies or dreams and visions where people have seen themselves going up during the time that cities were dressed in Christmas decoration. And that was one of the reasons I personally believe that perhaps the rapture would take place in the end of 2017 around the Hanukkah, which was still ignorant for me to think that because all the other signs that the Lord has given us have not been fulfilled at that time. That is to war break out in Israel and so forth, as much has to happen before the rapture takes place. The vial judgment following the trumpet judgments after the second rapture, and apparently for those who have received the mark of the beast. And so I was concluding that Revelation chapter 9, when the Antichrist is revealed, when the abyss is open, when all evil is coming upon the face of the earth, then we should be already redeemed and transfigured, and then will come all this evil. But that is happening after the fourth trumpet judgment, not after the seventh. March is the time when the Holy Spirit comes upon us, the fire of God is coming upon us, when we are actually receiving the fullness of Christ, full consciousness, seven spirits of God, engulfed in the fire of God, into the Holy Spirit, and we start walking as Jesus walked.
At the appointed time for the manifestation, April 2018 is the appointed time. And that is for sure. That is the time of redemption and the time that the bride is transfigured into the man-child.
And then the man-child will be caught up to the throne before Satan tries to devour him. So therefore, the man-child burns at the Passover. There's the fire of God. There's the transfiguration of the bride, Holy Spirit visitation. But the rapture is not yet. I believe the rapture is not yet. This is something that we all need to continue praying about. But most importantly, this is the time that we start walking out our call and set our minds on things above and not on earthly things, because the earthly things will be very taxing, very hard for everyone. We must stay above and we must know that we can rest in the Father's arms and this is the time, this is our time of manifestation. As we read it in Revelation chapter 12, Satan tries to devour the child, and the child is caught up to the throne, actually at the time the asteroid impact takes place, because the next verse in the scriptures is that then Satan was wrath with the woman and spewed water after the woman, and the earth opened up and swallowed up the water. And that is the tsunami and the earthquake. The tsunami is the spewing of the water, and the earthquake and the dividing of the land is that the water was contained and the earth swallowed up the water. So it appears to me that it's a major event that is, of course, the most devastating major event that will come, the asteroid impact that will shake up the whole earth, followed by the earthquake and the tsunami. And that is the era when the man-child will be cut up. So the man-child born at the Passover. The transfiguration takes place at the Passover, but the cutaway will not take place until the asteroid impact, and it's not in March. Thank God for that. It's not in March. Now, apparently, in the end of March, we are going to receive the fire of God. That is the second Pentecost. That is for the coming revival. We're going to receive the fire and the greater works anointing as the apostles have received it in the upper room. After this, we are going to start working on our callings and on the harvest until the rapture. Actually, it all begins to make sense to me. I was in church one time and I knew that I was one of the few chosen, one of the 144,000. And it was obvious that the other people in the church had no revelation of the kingdom. They weren't one of the chosen. But in one prophecy, the Lord said that I'm going to be raptured and them. And that I could not understand at the time because I knew there will be a rapture for the first fruits. And I knew that they are not first fruits. But the Lord also revealed to us over the years that at the time of the rapture, at the 3 days of darkness, where there will be a visitation, then he will still allow souls to enter the kingdom because they have repented, but they would not become the bride. So this is it. Those who are chosen, those who are transfigured at the time of the Pentecost are the bride. But those who will repent during this short time of revival and come into the rapture, they will not become the bride, but they will come into the first rapture. And after the first rapture happens at the asteroid impact, then the 144,000 is sent back to lead the woman, the church, into safety. That's when we need the safe havens. That's when we hide the woman from the wrath of Satan in the wilderness. And the woman will receive the two wings of an eagle, which is the two witnesses, the prophetic, to go through the great tribulation until the second rapture, when everyone who came into the harvest, everyone who yet repented and have not received the mark of the beast, can come into the kingdom. As I have said earlier, the purpose of judgment is repentance. Of course, on the end of the tribulation will be just judgment over those who departed from God. But until the shaking begins and until there is hope for the rapture, the shaking is for repentance. So those who will see the financial collapse and then see that they missed the mark receiving the fire of God and hearing us to prophesy what will come will repent and come into the rapture. Now, I also began to understand why this asteroid impact message so took me over. Because this is, I always said, this is not my calling. My calling is to build a safe haven and teaching of kingdom living and establishing kingdom establishment on the earth. But why was I so overtaken by this asteroid impact prophecy when I first heard it in 2015? Ever since, it didn't left me, and I was just wrapped up around it because I now see how much it is part of the call, how much it is changing everything. This understanding is imperative to move in this era. And it's just now dawning on me how all is related.
I'm praying over everything, and I believe I bring you the truth. But you see, in this case, the Lord made it clear to me that there was an error in my presentation concerning the events leading up to the rapture. Maybe it's just the timing of the events that includes the error, but it's errors. I'm sure that's what he wanted to protect me from, sending out that email. Praise the Lord. So I'm sure that is the timing is off schedule. So it looks to me that at the Passover we received the fire. And as the Lord said, now you run the race. And at the impact of the asteroid, there will be the rapture. Now, I have not posted yet the two parts, which would be after the fourth trumpet, the fifth, sixth, and seventh, because that is taking us to Revelation chapter 9, when the abyss is opening, when the Antichrist is revealed. And as we know, the Antichrist will not be revealed until the
man-child
is taken. So therefore, at that presentation, I concluded that the abyss will open up basically at the time of the rapture. I lost those two recordings in which I talked in details about the opening of the abyss and the revealing of the Antichrist. And I will not post those anymore. I don't think they are that important. We are going to experience it, and we need to keep our head above all these things as opposed to embrace them. And certainly before all this evil is coming upon the earth, we have to be transfigured into our spiritual form to be able to keep the joy. Now, as I was recording this segment of the video, this revelation came to me, which usually is the case that as I speak, I receive new revelation simply because I tap into the problem. And until we have a question, there is no way to receive the answers. I believe that's what's happening. So as I was talking about the coming Pentecost and the end of March, that we would be transfigured, and yet a separate time for the rapture, this is what came to me. The Lord said in prophecy about the 144,000, which I studied excessively years ago, He said that the bride will go through everything that He went through. And what did He go through? He was transfigured, and then He has risen and stayed on earth for 40 days among the people. So He has manifested Himself in His glorified form. And then He ascended. So may that be that we are going to stay in our glorified form until the rapture and do the work God has for us, now empowered by the Holy Spirit, and have received full consciousness and clarity of what the Lord wants to accomplish and how He do it. So there will be a supernatural acceleration and provision to run the race. I believe that is a possibility. So I bring it to you because this would be a very interesting and important aspect of our process of ascension and accomplishing the Father's will in the earth realm. Now, I looked it up where that 40-day would take us, and it comes to May the 10th, and I looked up what Jewish holidays might be in that time, which we know is not really a holiday season, but I have found one on May the 19th and the 20th. The Shavuot, the Feast of Weeks, which marks the giving of the Torah. Now, from the time of transfiguration of the Lord Jesus Christ, there were a few days prior to His crucifixion. If we add those days, which I don't exactly know how many days He was transfigured prior to the crucifixion, then it could be coming to exactly to the time of Shavuot. And giving of the Torah means the giving of the Word of God. And who is the Word of God but Jesus? Now, I'm not saying this is how it's going to happen, but I'm bringing it to you as a very interesting coincidence. Now, we know there are no coincidences in the spirit, but certainly do not know if this would come to pass. But if it would be so, that from our time of transfiguration, we would have 49 days till the rapture, it would exactly take us to this celebration of the Feast of Weeks, Shavuot, starting on the eve of May 19 and going through 20 and 21st in 2018. Praise the Lord. And that followed by the Jewish Rosh Hashanah New Year, on September the 10th, which also is the time of new beginning, which I understand contradicts the previous statement I made that we have seen the rapture taking place around winter time. So I'm not saying any of these will come to pass the way I present it to you. This is just something I want you to be aware of and pray about. And I just leave it right there. And then I was thinking that the other alternative would be that the prophecy that is well established that the rapture would take place right at the asteroid impact or during the tsunami, that it would be the second rapture at mid-tribulation, when the rapture would include everyone who came into the kingdom, all the newcomers, the repentant ones, every soul that was harvested through the great soul harvest. That too is very unlikely because it would contradict many prophecies. Because one of the prophecies from a well-trusted source said that the asteroid impact will take place between March and the end of 2018. Also, Prophet Rodriguez's prophecy that talks about the asteroid impact at Puerto Rico is the beginning of all judgments, is the punishment of the left behind church. Especially in his region, there is a lot of witchcraft and satanic sacrifice and satanic activities which the Lord will bring to judgment. In other words, if this is not the rapture during the mid-tribulation, and yet there is a rapture during the asteroid impact, which is established through many dreams and visions, then at the Passover comes the transfiguration and illumination when we actually transform into our eternal form and belong to heavenly places, thus the redemption is certain, and there is a spiritual change, but the actual removing everyone from the earth, and especially those who remain in the spirit form at the time of the tsunami or at the time of the impact, would be the actual rapture. And in the time in between, as I said, we would do the manifestation. All of us would do the manifestation. And the 144,000 would return after the asteroid impact, as it is in Revelation chapter 14. So these are all questions and topics that we need to pray about. I don't have all the answers. And with this, I truly conclude all this subject area and focus on my call as opposed to trying to receive more revelations about the coming events. So at this point of time, I'm just not going to investigate this any further. It's not important. The important part is that we have still time to pursue our cause, and the Lord is calling us to swing into action. So let me give you the scriptures He gave me from which I came to a greater understanding what He is trying to tell me. Now you hear the birds are chirping, praise the Lord. It's a beautiful day and we are here, the back of the house, in the nature. And it's about 15 to 20 degrees outside after the rain. Okay, let me continue with the scriptures in the next message because I don't want to make it long, and also these are two different subjects that is pressing towards the mark of the high calling to work out our cause. And it's so very important. So I start a new message with that. God bless you. Much love.